you see this coming. You're known as one of the closest supporters, or the most avid, one of the most avid supporters of President Duterte. Now you found yourself jobless. Did you see this coming?
I'm not jobless, by the way, but
in the context of the SSS.
The SSS. Yes, I knew exactly, 100% sure that this was coming, and in fact, I had probably brought it to a head with strategic intent, Christian.
What do you mean by strategic intent?
Well, Christian, why did I know it was coming first? I knew it was coming because somebody from the palace talked to me face to face, and his exact words, if you don't toe the line, then I forget the second part, but if you don't toe the line, you'll be sorry na lang. You'll be out of office, basically. And this was in the context of the charges I had filed at SSS against employees there and officers there.
The 21 officials?
21 and then the 4 for investments.
Mm.
And but one of them is in both, so about a total of 24 people. And it was in that context. There were many other topics, but that was the one that stood up.
What exactly did this so-called Malacanang official want you to do? To withdraw the cases?
Well, when I entered the room, his first question was, he did not direct it to me. He directed it to Chairman Valdez and said, what is this I hear? What is happening? People are filing cases left and right.
Mm.
Right? So he didn't say stop filing the cases. So, and then he looked at me and I said, well, you know, I found evidence of wrongdoing there, violations of the law. And if I don't do anything, I will be liable. I asked, what should I do? And he said, well, I'm not going to tell you what to do. But, you know.
When did this happen? And who was this official?
I cannot name the official for now. He's actually a friend of mine. And in his words, in Bisaya, amigo tabay, kauban ta sa kampanya. So, translated, we are friends and we were together in the campaign. But he also mentioned that there were people very close to the president, and I don't know if it's true. Somebody the president really trusts that was bothered by all the
investigations.
But I don't know if it's true. That's what he said. But Secretary Sonny Dominguez came out with a statement yesterday. He was asked by Philippine Star, and he said he did not know about this. He was surprised.
Now, how do you respond to the president's statement yesterday? He said your sacking had to do with the abuse of public funds.
Yes.
Basically lumped together with that, what happened, for example, at CHED. He mentioned CHED, Chapa
yes,
Marina.
Yes. Well, my first reaction when I saw first the article in Rappler, sabi ko sarili ko, to si Pia Ranada, princess talaga of fake news. But then to be fair to Pia, I also listened to, I actually haven't heard the actual interview, but
yeah, let's focus on what the president
yes,
said.
I had my staff transcribed it, and he does mention, including the SSS, when he was talking about the abuse of
public funds. Though.
Public funds. So I wasn't sure how to react. I don't know if that's what really what he meant, because I had heard Secretary Roque say it was a rift in the SSS,
yeah.
And what's the other thing he said? No reason given, which I accept.
Oh.
I'm there as a presidential appointee. But when I looked at the transcript, it looks like he is referring. And I was thinking, should I respond? I was weighing it. But at the end of the day, Christian, I have 3 children, and they're above any other concern, any political concern. I have 2 sons and a daughter, one who shares my name.
Mm. So,
and I cannot let it pass. Mm. It is the words, I'm not saying the president, but the words uttered, if that is what is meant, is unfair, untrue, and unjust.
Mm-hmm.
Unfair because I was never even told that there was an issue there about abuse. No due process, no chance to even answer, or what is this abuse?
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know. Untrue because I have not abused public funds. And unjust because, you know, people who know me, even Duterte supporters, No, that I have not done anything there even close to that. The only thing I've done there is protect the interests of 35 million SSS members.
Now, I remember during previous conversations, you mentioned that the president's marching orders was to, of course, root out corruption, alleged corruption, within the state-run pension fund. And that was what you have been doing, supposedly. Pero
I now, did not say that. I mean,
ganun yung context. Na,
well, you can see on the television, on TV, on radio, that is the centerpiece of his program, and that's why I supported him.
And yun yung ginagawa in the context of the investigations. But now that you were the one removed,
yes.
So how do you feel about this?
I don't take it. I really am not sure if he's charging me with corruption, but definitely I will not be quiet and not defend myself, because I am sure of what I've done. I have not abused public funds. It's the opposite. I've done everything to protect public funds there.
Hindi kaya na kayo yung supposedly nagpo-pursue ng anti-corruption drive supposedly within the pension fund. Kayo yung tinanggal. At the very least, baka naman mali yung direction.
Maybe he doesn't like it. I would not like to second guess the president on what the reason is. I would, if the reason is because of yung what's the Tagalog word that
hidwaan,
that's true. There is a differences in opinion, a difference in principles, a difference in ideologies there on the board. And you know, a board that's united is not the right. A board is supposed to have diverse opinions, diverse stance. And these are all at professional level.
Pero do you think na, no, looking back, somehow you might have overstepped your responsibilities, overdid certain things? Kasi ang impression na iba sa inyo, you had been filing cases left and right. And which a lot of people also within the pension fund found quite unfair.
Correct. But I have no regrets. I stand by it. I think when these cases are finally heard, I will be vindicated. Like, for example, the media contracts, Christian, these are not from thin air. These are written contracts with their signatures that did not go through the back, did not follow process. And, you know, the procurement law, as tedious as it is the law. Mm-hmm. And it's all about procedure. If you don't follow the procedure, then you have violated the law.
Ingay, parang impression sa'yo masyado kayong stricto na parang nitpicker. Diba? May mga ganong reklamo eh.
Yes, if you consider that nitpicking, then I would be happy to say that I'm a nitpicker. Okay.